It's terrible, you know, about just where math came from. You know, all of the pictures that they've shown out of Africa, they've never really educated the Americans, white or black, about what really goes on in Africa, what some of the cities are really like. And that we're not running around over there with Tarzan, you know, and when they show anything from Africa, even down to today, they pick the worst scenes, the most terrible situations, you know, and they show those. But we have a proud history. But of course, what we did in Egypt 5,000 years ago, or what we did in China 35,000 years ago, is of no benefit if we don't understand what to do today and how that would help us to survive. We discovered the clock. We did discover the wheel. Black man has never been a caveman. You've never been in a cave. There's no history of it. You've ever been in a cave. We discovered mathematics and the alphabet, and writing, and all of those great things that they have built a foundation on, that they came and got and took back to other countries. We don't know what Africa would be like without the white influence. We don't know what it would be like without the Rockefellers and De Beers and all of them. We don't know what Africa would have been like. We do know that there were greater places in Africa other than Egypt, which is the only one they let us know about.
Concurrently and simultaneously during the Pyramid Age, there are great things happening in West Africa. But very seldom. There are nations known as Dartichit. Dartichit is now, would geographically presently be located where Ghana is. We had the Nok culture, which is where we today would call Nigeria. We have the Monomotapan Empire in what today we call Zimbabwe. There are over 300 stone structures in southern Africa. And then you have that great structure in the great Zimbabwe that shows a direct relationship to the Grand Lodge of Luxor in Egypt. You have Pwani, which is in today's Somalia, Ethiopia. You have the Kush empires that are simultaneously happening. When Hatshepsut, the great pharaoh king, although she was a woman, she was a pharaoh king, sitting on the throne of Kemet, her cousin sits on the throne of Pwani, or what we call Somalia. There are great things happening historically across the African continent. You have the kingdoms of Kuba and Luba in Central Africa.
Mansa Musa was the king of Mali in the 1300s, very wealthy brother. During the dark age of Europe was going through a dark age, Africa was thriving. It was the gold capital. Mansa Musa was considered the wealthiest man on the planet at the time. Mansa Musa had a very well-known pilgrimage to Mecca, where he went to Egypt and went to Mecca and went through Egypt, and he gave out so much gold, it threw off the Egyptian economy. In today's terms, Mansa Musa gave away what would be the equivalent of $100 million in gold.
The African was the first race to circumnavigate the entire globe.
All over Africa, all over the world, the peoples of color that they call Africans, Afro-Ghanaians, we were all over the world. So to say that in Ghana, they had the Ashanti, all over, we had powerful dynasties, so innumerable we couldn't even name them, because remember, we had hundreds of thousands of years, and that's the secret. They cut us off at 6,000 because anything beyond that they could say is mystery, they could say is myth. So when you control the information, which is essentially what they've learned to do, under the Vatican they have about 6 to 8 miles of storage space that have all of our artifacts. And the Virgin Mother being black, all of the faces. We have to take apart the layers that are actually constructed in the lie. They're layered. For instance, you have a discipline in academia called Egyptology. Now, what is Egyptology? They say, well, it's the study of Egypt. Well, no, it's not the study of Egypt. Egyptology was created by the Vatican in order to make sure that there was a screening mechanism in place to explain away the truth that was being excavated every year, that kept giving them proof of who the ancient Kemites were. So Egyptology and Egyptologists are essentially agents of disinformation. Where else do you see a society, a people, and a way of life actually become a science? unless you have specific purposes to make sure that the information that you are gathering on those people are given the proper perspectives to maintain the lie. So you don't get an Americology, you don't get Europology, you don't get Russiaology.
Richard Pryor, right? When he had his special back in 1977, there's a scene. They only allowed him to do 5 shows. In fact, they were rather ignorant because it took them 5 shows to realize what the brother was really doing. Richard Pryor, there's a scene where he goes in to the pyramids and he is carrying the bags of the archaeologists and the anthropologists who are of European descent. And they're talking amongst themselves about what this find is and its importance, the greatness of it. And Richard Pryor is in this temple looking all around. And he begins to say, all these people are black. He said, look at that guy over there. That guy looks like my uncle. And he's just, you know, I mean, it's humorous. But what Richard Pryor is actually talking about is that, you know, these are black people in these pyramids, and these are the people that built these pyramids. He said, wait a minute, these people. And then all of a sudden, the camera begins to show the anthropologists of European descent, and they start to nudge each other because they realize, hey, you know, the guy carrying the bags is looking around and he's learning some things in here. So very quietly, you see them backing out of the pyramid, right? And Richard Pryor is still there talking about how great the pyramid is, and then all of a sudden, they show you the door closed, and all of a sudden, the scene goes black. Which means that was the blackout on the information for black folk to understand their history. This is what Richard Pryor was dropping on us in 1977. This is what actually has happened. Richard was telling us, this is what has happened to us. Because as you become conscious and brother becomes conscious and as a community we become conscious, the Europeans who know this are beginning to realize. So they're trying to shut the door on us.